Guys, welcome back. So in this video I will talk about how to remove the matching node from linked list, right? So before that I spoke about how to remove the node from the beginning, how to remove the node from the end, and now we'll see that how to remove the matching node. So to start with, I'll create one singly linked list. So let's say we have a linked list which has four nodes, right? And each node is connected, and head will point to the first node, and the last node will always point to null. So when we say node, node is the object. Object will have a data and pointer of the next node. So let's say data is equal to 2, this node data is equal to 3, this node data is equal to 4, and this node data is equal to 6. Okay, now since this is node, which is nothing but object, and when we create object we get a space in the heap memory, right? We get a space memory in the heap area. So this particular node, head node, this is nothing but head node, which has an address of 100. This guy has an address of 200. This node has an address of 300, and this has a address of 500. So basically this address of second node will be stored here, the address of third node will be stored here, and so on, right? Because that's how we identify how nodes are connected in the memory, right? Because every node will have a data and reference of the next node. Now when we talk about we need to remove the matching node, right? So let's say we need to remove this node, matching node, right? 4, and the data is equal to 4 and it has an address, so we need to remove that. So how we should approach for the logic? Okay, so when we start, you know, writing a logic, we need to think about all the combination, because you know that what node you need to remove, but you don't know the input linked list which is supplied by the caller, right? Caller in the sense of, let's say you have a method designed to remove the node, matched node, from the linked list, and that method is called by the multiple other methods. So you don't know when the method, when your method will get called, what input will be supplied to your method, right? So we need to handle all the condition. So the first condition should be, first what you do is you create one temporary node where you store the head reference. So you create one node temp is equal to head, okay, and write first condition. If the first word we need to write, that is if temp is equal to null, right? If this is the case, then do we need to remove any node? No, right? Because your linked list itself is empty. In that case you just return null, right? That is going to be your first condition, right? So once you are done with the first condition, what should be your second condition, right? So the second condition is going to be, if let's say there could be a requirement that your head is not pointing to null, right? Which means, you know, your linked list has a data. So what we can do here is we can just write whatever node. So basically your method input is going to be one node, okay, the one node which you are going to remove, right? So you have a method which will accept one node, right? So you have a public static void, public let's say public node and remove node, and then you have one method name. So let me write the method name so that, you know, it will be clear for you guys. So you have a method called public, node is the return type, and you have method called remove. This will take one node which is nothing but n. Now it is clear for you, this is your method, okay? So if this node, particular node dot equals, if let's say if this equals to temp, right, it could be the case that your the node which you are planning to remove, that can be equals to your head node also, right? If that is the case, so what we have to do that is we need to move the head, right? So whatever head you have, head is equal to head dot get next, right? And return temp, because temp is the one where you have stored the head, right? What does mean by this, guys? Why I have wrote like this? So assume that the method which is trying to remove the node, which can match with your head node also. If that is the case, in beginning, if you look at, your head was pointing here. If this head node itself is matching, because this node you want to remove, right? So basically your connection should get cut from here and your head should point here, correct? When head has to point here, then you know you have to reset your head. Head is equal to head dot get next, and automatic head will point here. So this is condition number second, right? Two conditions you have handled, right? Now assume that this first two did not got executed, which means both are the conditions did not get fulfilled. So what is the other conditions, right? Let's see that the other conditions, how it will look like. So the other condition is going to be, we need to run one while loop and we have to see that which node is matching, right? So run one while loop, while, so what you write in the while loop, in beginning you have started with this temp is equal to head, right? So just write temp dot get next if not is equal to null, right? Temp dot get next is not is equal to null, and when you say temp dot get next not is equal to null, so before, you know, before starting with these conditions, let me explain you so that you can understand this program. And before that, I need some space in this. So what I will do is I will try to remove some of the text which I have written. Okay, so let me do that. So this both conditions we have seen that, so I'm going to remove this first and second condition. Okay, because I have to explain again, then only I can, if I'll write the code, you can understand better. So try to understand, guys. Let's say you have this linked list, and now the given node is this node, right? Given node is this node. So you have to remove this. So what you have to do logically? Logically, the second node is pointing to this node. So logically, what you need to do that is you need to cut the connection from here, and this guy should point here, right? That's how you have to write, because we are going to remove this. So we need to cut the connection here, and this guy should point here, correct? So when we start with the while condition, while temp dot get next not is equal to null, right? If this is the case, if this guy is not is equal to null, and then we have to store this into one of the variable, right? We have to store this one of the variable, because the problem here, what happens is when you are keep on moving this data, right, keep on moving this data, and inside the while conditions, what you have is you have one if conditions. That guy role is to make sure that your particular field, when you are moving the node, that node, if dot equals to the given node, dot equals to this node, right? So we need to store this into one of the variable, right? So similarly, you create one more, assume that node, let's say C1, is equal to null, and here you write C1 is equal to, and then here you write if C1 dot equals, if this guy equals to n. So if this guy matches, right, if this guy equals to n, right, so what we have to do, that the moment your node matches, which means let's say just think about the iteration here, we did temp dot get next, so your C1 is here, right, your C1 is here, and assume that your node is getting matched. So what you have to do, if your node is getting matched, then where was the temp? Temp is here, right? So what you have to write here is temp dot set next, right? Temp dot set next. What you can do when you are going to set this, and when this guy is matching, so just you can go and you can do temp dot set next is equal to, you can just write here C1, not C1, you can write here C1 dot get next. Understood this line, right? So if this C1 equals to n, if this node matches with the node which you are looking for, then your temp is behind, your C1 is ahead, so your temp is still here, right? You started with here, your temp is still here. So temp dot set next, C1 dot get next, so C1 is already pointing here, so C1 dot get next, which means it is here, it is here. So already what will happen, this guy will start pointing here if this matches, right? If assume that this did not match, then what we have to do, we have to reset the temp, because we are running the loop, so we have to write temp is equal to C1, right, and close the while condition. So understood now, if did not matches, then what you do is you reset the temp, so temp is equal to C1. Now let's say I am looking for node number 4. So again the iteration will go, it will not go inside if condition. Your temp got reset now, your temp is also pointing here now, where the C was pointing. Now C1 is equal to temp dot get next, temp dot get next, your C1 came here, right, and C1 dot equals to node, the node which you are looking for. Yes, it is matching, I was looking for 4. So when I was looking for 4, so look at here, temp is the one. So temp is the one which has always previous data. You understood now? See why this is required, because temp is the one which has previous data. So your temp is still pointing here. When C1 moved here, temp is still here, right? So when you do temp dot set next and C1 dot get next, right? So what will happen is your temp is here. So this temp dot set next, C1 is already pointing to the 4, so it is going to set here, right? So that's how, you know, you can remove. And which node basically you have removed? You have removed this node, C1 node, right? You have removed C1 node. So then what will happen is you will set here, and here only I missed one line. Here only you can return, guys. Inside this if conditions only, no, you can always return this. So you write return temp, right? Because if you return from inside the if conditions, basically, you know, what will happen is, let me just, so this if has started here, and let me if this here. So why I am returning, guys, here? If I will return here temp, so that if I return the temp from here, so basically Sorry, I don't have to return temp guys because temp has previous data. Basically what we have removed here C1, right? So instead of temp, what you guys do is just write C1, return C1. You got it? Return C1 means which data you have removed? C1, basically C1. So that's how you should remove the matching node. Now the same thing I have written in the code also. Let me show you in the code so that you will understand how you can remove the matching node. So look at here, if the head is null, return null. If the particular node equals to head, right, either you do head or you do temp, both are fine, because when I was explaining, I store head into temporary variable. So if equals to head, so your head will move and you are returning the temp. So same logic whatever I have explained. So if your head is matching, right? Oh, what is happening? Yeah. So if you look at here, when your head is matching, you are moving the head and you are returning the temp. So basically you have again, you know, let me draw. I know I'm going a bit slow because this concept you need to understand, then only you can write this code. So this is your head, okay, and the last node is pointing to null. So if this head is matching, then what we have to do, we have to cut the head from here and your head should point here, correct guys? So this conditions will work for that. Now third conditions, let's say I want to remove, you know, this node, assume that. So look at here, in the temp I'm storing the head, and temp1, temp dot get next. So let's say in beginning your temp is pointing here, so you do, you know, temp dot get next not is equal to null. If not null, then you are comparing with the temp1, and when you are comparing it, so if let's say this matches, so when your temp is here guys, when your temp is here, right, when your temp is here, basically your temp1 will be here, right? Temp1 will be there. So in this case what happens is your temp1 is here. So what you have to do, we need to, you know, set this node to this node, right? So temp is always one node before to temp1. So temp dot set next is equal to nothing but temp1 dot get next and return the temp1. So when I explained, I wrote return c1, right? If condition matches, if not, then always go and refresh your temp, because again we need to run the loop, and that's how you can remove the matching load. So matching node. So I hope in the interview you'll be able to write this program. Thank you guys, thank you for watching this.